What is good, Mexit planners? A few months ago, I made a video entitled Don't Get Fired, Essential Information That You Need to Know About VPNs. In that video, I broke down what virtual private networks are and exactly how they work. Well, today I want to show you the hardware and software VPN technologies that I use and demonstrate the best hardware VPN router that I found. Let's get it. So before we get into the technical details, I wanted to tell you exactly who this video is for. This video today is for the expat living in another country that would like access to the content of US streaming services, and it's for the remote worker that would like their location of their computer to appear to be in a different physical location, like the United States. However, I want to give the remote workers a word of caution. This video is for informational purposes only, and I take no responsibility for your employment or lack thereof. If you're confused at all by this statement, please go back and watch the previous video that I did on VPN technologies. All right, with the legal disclaimer out of the way, let's talk about this cool little router that I've been using. When I created my previous video on VPNs, I fully intended to demonstrate the capabilities of the router I was using at that time. It was a smaller version of this new router, the GL iNet Slate ATX1800 that I'm using today. The Slate ATX1800 is a fairly new product for GL iNet, and it does everything that the previous router, the GL AR750, did, and so much more. The first thing that attracted me to the Slate 1800 is its small portable size and powerful features. The Slate ATX1800 is loaded with features for the digital nomad, remote worker, and traveler. It features Wi-Fi 6 with the fastest available speeds of 1.2 gigabits per second on the 5 gigahertz channel and 600 megabits per second on the 2.4 gigahertz channel. The Slate 1800 also features 3 gigabit Ethernet ports, 2 for the LAN and 1 WAN port. This fast little router will handle your streaming, your gaming, and anything else with ease if you have a high-speed internet connection. The second thing that I love about this router is its versatility. This router offers Wi-Fi 6, gigabit Ethernet, network access storage or NAS drive capabilities, up to 512 gigabytes of storage, which means you can have a shared file server in your home just by inserting a mini SD card into this router. You can also connect up to 120 simultaneous wireless devices to this little router, and it offers multi-WAN support, which gives you the ability to connect several different internet connections to this device and use them for load balancing or for failover. I'm gonna demonstrate this multi-WAN feature for you a little bit later in this video, but the main feature that I'd like to talk about on the Slate ATX1800 is the VPN client and server capabilities right out of the box. So let's talk VPN. With many routers, it is a common feature to allow you to set up a server-side VPN to connect two remote locations together. This is known as site-to-site VPN. Basically, you create a tunnel in between two different locations. What is less common is for a router to also offer the ability to connect as a client to a VPN software service like NordVPN. I use NordVPN software service because it is so versatile. It offers the ability to be installed on everything from my iPhone, iPad, Mac, Fire Stick, and Android devices. It even works right out of the box with the Slate ATX1800 just by entering my NordVPN credentials and using the OpenVPN protocol. On the AR750 router that I had prior to this one, I had to import the configuration files, but on the Slate ATX1800, I simply tell it where I would like to connect, and it downloads the configuration files from the NordVPN software servers. I was up and running with a virtual private network within minutes of installing this router. The beauty of having the NordVPN software on my router is that every device connected behind the router can be on the VPN tunnel. Now, I emphasize the word can because this router also offers the ability of doing VPN policy routing, which is pretty darn cool for a VPN hardware router like this. I currently have my Slate ATX1800 set up so that only the traffic over the Mexit Plan's VPN network goes out over the VPN to the internet. You could also set up this router to only route the VPN traffic to streaming services like Hulu, Discovery Plus, or Netflix, or other services that don't offer service in maybe the country that you live in. The last VPN feature that I love about the Slate ATX1800 is the speed of the VPN connection. My primary reason for upgrading to the Slate from the GL AR750 is that the GL AR750 only offered 13 megabits of speed over the VPN connection using the OpenVPN protocol. If I use the WireGuard protocol on the previous router, I could get up to 50 megabits per second. However, on the Slate ATX1800, I can get VPN connection speeds up to 120 megabits on the OpenVPN protocol and a whopping 550 megabits using the WireGuard protocol. 120 megabits is plenty of speed over a VPN tunnel to do just about anything. The last feature I want to highlight is the ability to have different types of WAN connections simultaneously connected to this router. WAN connections are wide area network connections on a router are your internet connections. If you're in Mexico, for example, this would be internet service providers like Telmex, Izzi, or Total Play for your home internet. You might also have a cellular service from Telcel if you can't get cable or fiber to your home. Or perhaps like me, you have the ability to use your phone as a hotspot. Well, that is where this little Swiss Army knife of a router really shines. I can connect my fiber Telmex service as my primary internet connection on the WAN port. And at the same time, I can tether my iPhone using USB as a backup hotspot. Now, this is really, really cool. Let me explain what this does. If my fiber Telmex device goes down for some reason, someone cuts my cable, I lose internet connection because Telmex is not up and running, and I still have cell phone service, this router will automatically switch me over to my hotspot and use my cell phone as backup internet. Incredibly cool feature. This is a huge capability for remote workers, and it would be worth buying this little device for the ability to use your cell phone as an internet provider to all of the wireless and wired devices behind this router. Buying this router will give you a viable backup internet service to whatever you currently have if you have a hotspot capability on your phone. That is a really cool feature, and you don't see those type of capabilities in commercial, small, portable travel routers like this. I'm gonna put the link to my recommended products page in the description of this video below. NordVPN is offering an amazing deal for Black Friday, up to 68% off the regular price. If you don't have NordVPN, now is the time to get it. Also, the Slate ATX1800 VPN router is on sale for $129 using the affiliate link in the description below. I appreciate your support by using the link. Also, and if this video has added value to your life, please consider sending a super thanks. All right, so let's take a look at some examples of the internet connection over the VPN router. The first example is trying to connect to the government website for my local energy co-op in Atlanta. This was a task that I had to do every month when I owned a home in Atlanta still. We had to go and pay the utility bill every single month. Well, as you can see, I can access the utility.org website very easily. However, when I go to make a payment, the firewall at the co-op blocks foreign traffic. This is not an uncommon firewall policy for state and local governments or even federal government entities for services that shouldn't really be accessed from outside of the country. This is a very common policy for things like your utilities, also your school districts. This is a super common firewall policy for most companies to have. For the second example, let's take a look at streaming services like Netflix. Once I'm connected over the VPN, I appear to be in the United States and I get access to the US catalogs of movies. So you'll know that by, it'll say, here's what's trending in the US today. Also, it works great for services like Hulu and Discovery Plus and others that don't offer service out of the country as of yet. If you want to know the specifics on how VPNs work and what to watch out for if you're a remote worker, check out this video over here. Until next time, Mexit Plans Monty, I'm out.